That's right, Chris. But before we get to all that stuff, you know, the majority of athletes out there, or pretty much all, are not 4 or 5-star recruits, but that doesn't mean you can't have a dream to play at the next level and have an impact.
Yep, true, and redshirt freshmen are making an impact right now at the college level, like Jameis Winston, right. Tyler Boyd, Robert Kimdiche are all impacting the college level. But right now, I want to bring in Max Preps national football editor, Steve Spiewak. Steve, how you doing?
Good, guys.
Good. I want to talk to you about some freshmen that weren't so lucky to have all those stars but are still contributing heavily.
Yeah, you know, it's always sad when a young man does not live up to his promise and has a disappointing college career. It's a lot more exciting when a guy kind of sneaks under the radar a little bit and outperforms expectations. And I think one of those guys so far this year is Cal freshman Jared Goff out of Marin Catholic just outside of San Francisco. Big 6'5" quarterback. He was ranked outside of the top 247 last year. He was a known kid, but he was not considered a true blue chip quarterback despite throwing for 3,692 yards and 40 touchdowns as a senior. And I think part of the reason, guys, is because he did not spend his offseason attending quarterback camps and showing up at combines. This is a kid that also played basketball and baseball. So a true three-sport athlete who looks like he has a very bright future ahead of him at Cal. Another guy, Washington State defensive back Daquan Brown, 6'175" as a senior last year at Dorsey High School, a school that has produced countless NFL players. He's sort of that new mold of a cornerback in that he's big, long, and rangy, and he can go up there and jump and out-catch a big, tall receiver. So he's kind of the wave of the future, and the reason he chose Washington State was because he wanted to play early. He had offers from UCLA and others, and he ended up in Pullman, and he's having a phenomenal freshman season for the Cougs. Another guy is former Lake Travis quarterback Baker Mayfield. Guys, this is a program that has produced two quarterbacks who are probably more heralded than Mayfield, Garrett Gilbert and Michael Brewer. And Mayfield threw for 6,255 yards and 67 touchdowns in his final two seasons at Lake Travis. So it's hard to imagine him flying under the radar, so to speak, but he was not thought to be a guy who was going to come in and make an instant impact, but clearly he has. And guys, don't be surprised you see him on the field of the diamond this spring, because he hit 338 last year at Lake Travis. Another guy having a big impact as a freshman, running back James Conner from Pitt out of McDowell High School in Erie, Pennsylvania. Kind of a throwback to the big physical backs that Western Pennsylvania is accustomed to. He rushed for over 1,600 yards and 21 touchdowns and is certainly bringing his physicality to the Panthers this year as a freshman. And finally, guys, Johnny Munt from Modesto Central Catholic, a guy who kind of blew up late in his career, was not on the radar for very long, fell in love with Oregon's facilities and committed there. But this was a guy that people thought may redshirt. Now he's making a big impact in that high-powered Oregon offense. As a senior, guys, only had 600 receiving yards and 8 touchdowns, and now he's playing a prominent role for perhaps the nation's best team.
So you're saying I have a chance?
No.
Okay. All right, but it does show you that hard work and determination does pay off, and some kids do grow a little later than others and then overtake those that have peaked early, like us.
Yeah, well, I don't think we've peaked yet.
Oh, thank you.
Maybe we have a chance.
Yeah, I hope so.